XFL opening day, the Seattle Dragons DC Defenders here at Audi Field. A lot of energy. We're about 45 minutes away from kickoff. People filing in, a lot of excitement in the air. We're going to go up in the booth with ESPN Steve Levy and Greg McElroy. Well, welcome in, everyone. We're standing here with Alabama national champion quarterback Greg McElroy and current ESPN analyst. Greg, how's the energy right now around the XFL?
Honestly, like, I'm blown away. I could not be more excited. Y'all, it's February, and we're starting a new league. Like, this league is kicking off today, and I don't think any of us know what to expect. And I think the nervous energy that I have right now is probably going to be the exact same nervous energy all these players have. You know, this is a unique situation that is very rare in this industry to be a part of something at its inception. And I just can't wait to see what we're going to get today, because I have as many questions as you do, as everybody at home does. It's going to be really, really a lot of fun.
Ton of excitement. You know, you don't get to get in on the ground floor of a professional major sport too often, right? The NFL started 100 years ago. So here's to the first year of 100 of XFL. And it's really a neat experience. I feel blessed to be here and lucky to be chosen for this. It's an important venture for my company, for ESPN and Disney, and for football fans everywhere. Let's keep the good times rolling.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the XFL.
What does the XFL need to do this time in 2020 to be around for the long haul?
Be predictable. I mean, I think that's the biggest problem with spring leagues in the past. For instance, last year, AAF, like, I watched the AAF because I love football. I'm addicted to football, literally. But I do think now, I know every single week, when I turn on ABC at 2 o'clock Eastern time, I know what's on. When I turn on Fox or ESPN on Sunday in the afternoon, I know what's on.
Look, I think first of all, that's sort of twofold, right? So on television, the product can be entertaining because of the innovations. I think it's going to be really cool on television. But you need people to come to the stadium and have a good time. It's got to be fan-friendly that way. And quite frankly, that comes back to the play on the field, the actual... You know, at ESPN, we can do just so much with the broadcast. The play's got to be good, and I think it will be good. Just about every one of these players has had at least a cup of coffee in the NFL. We've got a lot of guys who played, you know, 50 NFL games. So they all come from big Power 5 colleges, and I think the play will be good. It'll be interesting how teams separate themselves. Is there, like, one great team and one team that's not so good, or will they be league parity? We'll have to find out.
So fans watching at home who might be unfamiliar with some of the guys on these rosters,
yeah,
kind of put it in perspective for them. If the DC Defenders lined up against LSU, what would happen?
Did you hear me say that? I asked that question yesterday to McElroy in the car. So what would happen? So I always hate that, right? Because people say, hey, you know, like the Detroit Lions, for example, you know, could LSU beat the Detroit Lions or the Buccaneers? Of course, the answer is no, despite what fans think. I think it's 1 or 2% of college players play in the NFL. Now, in LSU, it's different. Obviously, they got maybe 20 NFL players. I get that. So I would think they probably wouldn't. LSU would obviously have the cohesive advantage of being a team and practicing together. And these teams are all new. But if you took another team, you know, not an LSU, let's say Penn State, for example, I would think the XFL team, after some months of practice and coaching, I would think the average XFL team would beat the average college team.
I think the DC Defenders would win. I mean, I really do. Now, granted, LSU has 16 NFL prospects that were starting in their 22. So there's something to be said for that for sure. But we're talking about professional athletes. We're talking about 30-year-old guys in some cases that have grown man strength.
Final question. We have a few rule changes,
yeah,
that are going to be different.
Yeah.
Which one are you most excited to see unfold?
A 10-minute halftime. How's that? No, halftime would be really fast. I'm not sure they're even going to leave the field. I like the 1 foot inbounds on a catch, the college rule, not the NFL. I think that will lead to more sensational catches, more offense, more points. And then, of course, the extra point, which you can't kick to get the extra point. We've been hearing from the coaches they will rarely try to get the 3-point play from the 10-yard line just because the percentages of being successful are rather unlikely. But that's going to be fun, and you know that's going to come into play late in the game. A team's down 9 points, you're still right there. Your team's down 8 points, coach has a decision, you can go for the win.
Well, fans, the XFL exceeded all expectations opening day when the DC Defenders beat the Seattle Dragons. The energy was high. As Greg McElroy and Steve Levy said in the ESPN booth, this league likely has a ton of staying power, a ton of talent that is in it. Lots of former NFL players there. The fans were loving it. The energy was through the roof. There's a lot of positives here. And I'm telling you all right now, if you're not already watching the XFL, you need to get on this hype train before there's no more room left, because we are in for a wild time over the next several games this season. Vince McMahon, Oliver Luck, both should be applauded big time. To all the players, incredible performance. To ESPN, absolutely incredible broadcast production. It was fun from start to finish. This is gonna be a special league. This is much more than just a spring football league. This is its own unique brand of football, and everybody has loved it so far. I encourage everyone to check out the XFL.